everyone. My name is Jason Martin, and I'm a technician here at Codasite. And today I'll be going over the Microsoft application known as Lync with you. So first of all, if you'll navigate to your Start menu, and then select Search, and type in Lync. And when Lync populates, right-click and select Pin to Taskbar, and then go back to your Start menu or desktop. And now, as you can see, Lync is pinned to my taskbar. And I will simply click to open. And once this comes up, please enter your company email address under sign in address, and then enter your password associated with that address. And this password will be the same as your Outlook account, SharePoint, etc. And then select sign in. Would you like us to save this info and sign you in automatically next time? Select yes. And then you'll get contacting server and signing in. And the first thing I like to tell people to do once they initially sign into Lync, across the top bar here, locate Tools, and then go to the bottom and select Options, and then select Personal, and then find the box that says Automatically Start Lync when I log on to Windows, and make sure that is checkmarked. And what that's going to do is every morning when you log into your machine, it will automatically turn Lync on, or start up Lync. You won't have to worry about turning it on every day. So that is checkmarked, and I will simply click OK to navigate away from that. And now just to go over a few features of Lync with you. As you can see, here's my name, Jason Martin. And across the top here, I can enter a quote of the day or a project I'm working on. And for those of you with social media, you can also upload a picture here. And then under my name, you'll see I have available set now, and that's associated with the green color. But I can hit the drop down and also set that to busy, do not disturb, be right back, off work, or appear away. Another thing I can also do is set my location. And to set my location, I'm simply going to click in the box. And today I'm on our Mooresville campus site. So I will enter Mooresville NC and select enter. And now everyone knows I'm at the Mooresville campus. That's where I'm working from today. And for those of you that may work from home via VPN, you can also select it again and simply enter home. And that will indicate where you're working at. The next thing I'm going to show you how to do is how to add contacts and groups to your Lync. So first of all, I'm going to locate the gentleman to the right here and click. And I'm going to go down and select create a new group. And I'll get this pop-up here. And the first group I'm going to create is my company group, so I'll enter my company name and select enter. And as you can see, now I've indicated this is my company and I've associated it with a group in Lync. I'm also going to select the gentleman again and go back down to create a new group. And say, for example, if you work at a company that does various projects with contractors or other companies, I'm going to enter a group called contractors and select enter. And now you can see I have two groups. I have my company group named Codasite and my contractors group. So next, to search for contacts, I would simply come up here to the find someone search bar and enter the person's full company email address. And once that email address is entered, it will give you options, and I will verify first and last name. And this is the Tim I was looking for, so I will simply right-click his name, go down to Add to Contacts List, and this gentleman is in my company, so I'm going to select the Codasite group. And now, as you can see, Tim is added to the Codasite group. Now, at the same time, if I was working with a contractor from another company with another email address, I could simply come up here and enter that address. It would populate their name. I would right-click, go to Add to Groups, and I could add them to the contractors group, and they would be here. So now, to show you a few features of Lync, I'll simply double click the person's name and I'll get a chat pop-up. And I have five options across the bottom here. The first one is a simple chat where I can type, hey, how are you, and they will respond. The second one is a Lync call where you can place a telephone-like call through the speakers of your computer. And the third one is video conferencing. And pretty much they can see you and you can see them. The fourth one, which I think is the coolest option, is going to be remote desktop. I can come here and select all monitors, or if you only have one monitor, it will say desktop. And Tim can then gain access to view my machine, or vice versa. I can gain access to view his machine. If he needs help on a project, or if he just needs some IT support, I can do it simply through remote access via Lync. And then the fifth option is the participants. It's just going to show how many people are involved in this current chat window. And I can invite more people. I can invite up to as many participants as I would like and send out a group conversation. So now that I've showed you that, my next thing is I'm going to show you how to remove a contact from a group and also remove a group. So if I wanted to remove Tim from my company group, I would simply right-click his name again and come down and select Remove from Group. Remove this contact from your contacts list and select Yes. And as you can see, it removed Tim. Also, if I wanted to remove contractors or another company that we are no longer working with on a project, I could simply right-click it, come down here, and select Delete Group. And as you can see, it deleted the overall group. And one of the last things I really like is right here. If you're involved in a chat with someone and working with someone on a project and you can't remember exactly what they could say, you can select your Conversations tab here, and it will save all the conversations you have previously had with people. So you can open it up, scroll back through it, and find out exactly what they said. Again, this is the Microsoft application known as Lync, and my name is Jason Martin. I hope you found this tutorial entertaining and informative, and I thank you for your time.